We have some regrettable news. The recount that was requested by Jessica Cisneros in her primary challenge against Democrat, technically Henry Cuellar, has turned out to not have reversed the results. And Henry Cuellar will be the nominee for that district. The final vote looks like it was 50.3% to 49.7%. It was so incredibly close. I mean, you know, 2 years ago it was very close. It was even closer this time. Almost anything being different would have shifted it. But no, instead of getting Jessica Cisneros, who could have been an awesome representative, we're stuck with one of the worst Democrats in the country. And Jessica Cisneros is taking the high road with her commentary about this, tweeting the results of the Texas 28 runoff are not what we had fought for. I am so grateful for the leap of faith so many of you took on this underdog race. I look forward to keep fighting for a more progressive and accountable Democratic Party and work to turn Texas blue in November. We always knew this was an uphill battle. We were up against a corrupt political machine, Republican funded super PACs, big oil, the Chamber of Commerce, dark money groups, big pharma, and nearly the entire Democratic Party establishment. And we still refuse to back down. With this close of a margin, it's clear that without their aggressive interference in the lives of South Texas families, we would have won. The biggest thing holding us back from pursuing the change we deserve is their fear. Fear of change, fear of the future. The only way you defeat fear is with courage and determination that in the richest nation in the world, we all deserve to thrive. Change is a process, and through this process, we're educating our community that we deserve better than the status quo. So yeah, she identified some of the things that influenced it. I don't know if it was the absolutely disgusting, completely thoroughly unacceptable billboards that he totally wasn't involved in that went up in the district. I don't know if it was Nancy Pelosi and other members of sort of senior Democratic leadership that decided that it was unacceptable to let the voters just decide to potentially have someone who actually represents the future of the Democratic Party. Instead, we need to have a guy who in any other state would be among the more conservative Republicans. We literally need a guy who doesn't want gun control and doesn't believe that reproductive rights should be up to the people exercising them. And so they took their political capital and time in a time of endless crises in America to go and work to get Henry Cuellar to keep his seat. It was an absolutely disgusting thing that Nancy Pelosi and other Democrats, including Jim Clyburn, chose to do, JR. And in the end, it seems like that was probably the deciding factor.
Yeah, I was gonna say, as you listed some of the potential reasons, or I guess the factors that went into this, I think the big part of it, of course, was the establishment of the party, making sure that they put all their money and effort and energy behind Henry Cuellar. Again, you pointed out some of his issues. I was gonna point those out too, the reproductive rights, openly about that. And not really much as far as trying to explain those away, especially as we've seen what's going to potentially happen with the Supreme Court and their draft decision there on Roe. And gun control. Hey, listen, the entire party, the Democratic Party, can't go around. It's gonna look this way, not because I think so, but the crying and the whining about what's going on with our gun situation, and then back someone who has the exact opposite belief system that you're whining and crying about. Then we can say you're just whining and crying because there's nothing behind your emotion. There's nothing behind your principles that you say you have as far as changing that. How do you change something that already have? We have an entire party that posts things like no gun bill and chants and boos down one of their major leaders for having some support behind red flag laws. You're fighting that party, yet you still include someone like Henry Cuellar, who's a part of that party and those stances. No one can take you seriously. The people that voted for you will probably wonder, so what do they believe? Because we just lost children again, and they're continuing backing people like this. What's it based off of? Based off of fear, and it's based off of just really not believing in what they're saying.
100%. Yeah, well, it is exactly that. This is not only, you know, a super conservative like guy on these major issues, but specifically in Texas, following these shootings, following Texas, being at the forefront of criminalizing abortion and trying to support your reproductive rights, they could have just not weighed in. They could have just let people choose. They would not do that. They did not find that to be acceptable. They had to have Trump's favorite Democrat. That's who they had to have at this time. As if they needed the opportunity to make sure that people knew that all of what they were saying about reproductive rights, about guns, all that is BS. They don't actually mean it. They're not interested in making sure that they have the majority necessary, robust, big enough, strong enough, passionate, and committed enough to get actual strong legislation passed. It's not actually about that. They like their incumbent. That's
and when the, and when these establishment Democrats lose, they will blame people like Jessica Cisneros.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.